Now, DNS domains are structured as a tree. Domains such as google.com and udacity.com do share something, the com top-level domain. There's actually a collection of servers who are responsible for storing all of the records for domains in com, and in org and edu and each other top-level domain, including country code domains like UK and IL and UA and US. Now, www.example.com is a subdomain of example.com, and test.www.example.com is a subdomain of that. Now, there's no rule that you can't have hosts at any level of these subdomains. You can have a host with an IP address and an A record on one domain, and then have a subdomain of that with a different host on it. Now, early in the history of the web, it was common for an institution whose domain was, let's say, stanford.edu, to have its web server at www.stanford.edu. And that would have typically been a single machine that was the web server representing the institution. But these days, since so many domains are used almost entirely for web traffic, many organizations skip the www and just point their domain directly to a web server, like github.com, for instance. The name www.github.com is a CNAME, an alias, for the A record github.com. Whether to use bare domains like GitHub does, or www domains like Udacity does, is pretty much a style and branding preference. There's little technical difference. For computers within an organization, it's pretty common for them to also have a configured search domain. This tells the resolver on that computer to look up hosts inside that domain first. Like if you're on the network of the university example.edu, you might have that in your search domain. Then when you look up the DNS name www, the resolver will look for www.example.edu first.